The Adjust Material Definition tool allows you to quickly change the look of materials that already exist within your plan. This tool will only be available when you're in a camera view. You need to be able to see the material to change it with this tool. So I'm going to open up a camera view within Chief Architect that I already have open. So while in this 3D view, I'm going to come up to the 3D menu, down to Materials, and go to Adjust Material Definition. We also call this the Rainbow tool. Notice that my cursor changes over to the rainbow, and now I can hover over any material. So for instance, I'm going to select this couch material, click on it, and it will open up the Define Material dialog. So from here, I can change many attributes of this material. If I come down to the Texture panel, this is where the picture of the material actually exists, as well as the source of the file of the material. So in this case, this is one that I actually imported into the plan. So from here, I can change the angle or the beginning position of the material. I can change its scale. I can change the color, so I can blend it with a different color. We'll explore some of these options here in a little bit. Right now, I'm going to change its scale. So I'm going to make it a smaller material to begin with. Let's do 20 by 20. Now, because I have this retain aspect ratio selected, when I change the X scale and hit Tab, it will automatically update the Y scale as well. Then I'll select OK. Now notice, not only did the material on the chair that I had selected change, but the material on the adjoining chair changed as well. And if this material was being used anywhere else in the plan, it also would have changed to accommodate the new scale that I have selected. This also can be the case when you select something like flooring. So if I click on this hardwood floor, open up the Define Material, come down to the Texture panel, and change the angle of this material, I'm going to change it to 90 degrees so we rotate it, and then I select OK. I have used this material in many other areas throughout my plan, including on the second floor. So that material has changed throughout the entire floor. The reason being, it's looking for the material name. So this flooring is called Back Bay. So when I adjusted the material, it found every instance of that material name throughout the plan, and it made the exact same adjustment. In addition, I updated the rotation of the texture without paying attention to the pattern. So right now, they are not aligned in the correct direction, which means right now I'm in my physical based rendering, which is going to make use of the texture. But if I switch over to a vector view, that is a view type that's going to make use of the pattern. So now it's showing my hardwood floor going in a different direction than the pattern. So whenever I select a material and I make any changes to the texture, I often will want to make sure that I adjust the pattern to compensate. So in this case, I'm also going to rotate its angle to 90 degrees. And when I adjusted the couch material, the upholstery, I didn't need to make any changes to the pattern because I didn't have a particular pattern selected. It's just a color area. But if I make changes to the texture scale, I want to make sure that I also update the pattern. So right now, it's a little hard to tell with this particular pattern, but this is 10 rows of hardwood. So when we're looking at the pattern, I have 10 rows of hardwood at an 80-inch scale, so they need to each be 8 inches wide. So with regards to the pattern, I'm going to come to my general panel, and I have an 8-inch height for my wood, which is exactly correct. So if I were to update the scale, for instance, 100 inches, I would want to also make sure that I updated the height of my strips to be 10 inches wide, which would also update the look of the pattern. As you can see, it adjusts here. Remember, we also rotated it so that now it aligns with our texture. So they match up and it looks correct in 3D. It looks correct in our vector view, and it also will be accurate for our material list because the material list is drawing from whatever you have here in your defined material. So now I'm going to choose a new material, again using the adjust material definition, which we also have a shortcut for here on our architectural toolbar. Now I'm going to click on the rug, and if we come down to the texture panel, notice this is selected to stretch to fit. So that means it's going to take this particular texture and it's going to stretch it across whatever object it's pasted onto. So this is an option typically used for rugs and also for TV screenshots if you're going to paste something into a TV, or a picture if you're going to put it in a picture frame. Anything that you don't want to tile but want to stretch across in the object you're pasting it onto. If you uncheck stretch to fit, it's going to tile the texture along an X and Y scale across whatever object you paste it onto. I'm going to reselect stretch to fit, and I also want to take a look at our blend with texture option. So if this color didn't fit in with the palette of the room, I can click to blend the color with the texture. You can notice my preview of the image has showed up here, it's changed. And I can click on that color and either type in an RGB value or I have an eyedropper. So I can grab that eyedropper, move over into the plan, select a material. In this case, it's pretty shadowed, so it's darker than I might want. So I might increase the saturation and maybe increase the luminosity so that it more clearly matches the material I'm looking for. Once I have the color selected, I can click OK. You can see it'll apply to that rug. Then when I click OK again, it'll apply it in the plan. And remember, it's going to make that change to any material in the plan that was also following that material name. So in this case, I also had a rug in the entry living room that was utilizing that material, so it will have updated as well. So you want to be a little careful with using this, making sure that you want to change that material throughout the entire plan. If you do not want to change the material throughout the entire plan, I'm going to undo that. And now instead of using the Adjust Material Definition tool, I'm going to come under the 3D menu, down to Materials, and open up my Plan Materials. So this is going to show me a list of all the materials that are currently used in my plan. So if you'll recall, that rug material is called Blue 4-Petal Rug. So I'll scroll until I find it, I'll select it, and now I'm going to copy that material. This is going to open up the Define Material dialog, and it's going to rename the material, comma, copy. So I can rename it something else, so I'm going to call it Blue 4-Petal Rug - Teal. Then come down to my texture panel, blend the color with the texture. Again, select a teal material, and I'll increase the saturation, increase the luminosity, and select OK. So now I have a new material called Blue 4-Petal Rug - Teal. I'll select OK. It's not going to do anything until I actually paste that material in the plan. Right now that material is not in use. So I'm going to use my Material Painter, which is here on my architectural toolbar. It's also under the 3D menu. And instead of using my library materials, I'm going to use my plan materials and find Blue 4-Petal Rug - Teal. Select OK. And then I'll paste it onto this rug. And now, any changes that I make with the Adjust Material Definition tool, so I'll click on this material, it's our Blue 4-Petal Rug - Teal, and let's say I want to actually make it gray, and then I uncheck Stretch to Fit, and I make it a smaller 12 by 20. Select OK, and you'll see the change that I made applied, but if we take a look in the living room, so I'm just going to push down on my scroll wheel and scroll over to the living room for a little bit. Use my rotate tool, rotate around. You can see there is another instance of the blue 4-petal rug, and it has not changed to the new settings that we used for the rug in the sunroom. And the reason for that is because it has a different name, and thereby the program sees it as an entirely different material.